That's unbelievable. So this is the bacteria on my phone, and this is the bacteria on a toilet seat. Are you sure that's right?
Yes, 100%.
That's pretty amazing.
Have you ever stopped and wondered just how dirty your phone is? Just think of all the places that you use it. On your commute, at work, at the dining table, and even in the toilet. Yes, you heard me right. Some people actually use their phone in the toilet, but I hope that's not you.
Scientists have found that your mobile phone carries 10 times more bacteria than a toilet seat. I know, I couldn't believe it either.
Now, the average person checks their phone about 47 times per day, which gives plenty of opportunities for the microorganisms from your fingers to go onto your phone. Now let's see what microbes are on my phone. So I've come to my old university, the University of Bradford, to find out more by doing some cool experiments. Dr Isreb from the Bradford School of Pharmacy knows his stuff when it comes to microorganisms.
Hi there.
Hi, good to see you.
Good to see you too. So I heard you're going to show me the microbes on my phone.
Yes, that's correct. Let's go.
So what have you tested today, Dr Isreb?
So we transferred the sample from your phone, your skin, toilet seat, clean phone into a petri dish to see what bacteria will grow there.
I'm really excited about this, but I'm also a little nervous as to what you're going to find.
So in terms of the number of bacterial colonies, your skin came on top, followed by your phone, toilet seat, and clean phone. So if we compare the number of bacteria on your phone to the toilet seat, we found there is significantly more bacteria on the phone.
That's unbelievable. So this is the bacteria on my phone, and this is the bacteria on a toilet seat. Are you sure that's right?
Yes, 100%.
That's pretty amazing.
So now that we've seen exactly how much bacteria is on my phone, is this something that we should be worried about?
Human skin is naturally covered in microbes that don't usually have a negative effect on our health. Here's a sample we took earlier from your skin compared to your phone.
So is there any bacteria that should concern us?
Actually, studies have found serious pathogens on our mobile phones, including streptococci, E. coli, and even MRSA. Viruses can also spread on phones. So if someone has a sore throat or influenza and hands their phone to a friend, they could potentially get it.
So these microbes, they won't make us automatically sick, but if they get into our system, they could potentially make us quite ill.
Exactly.
Fortunately, there's an easy way to cleaning your phone. All you need is a clean microfiber cloth, distilled or clean bottled water, a mini spray bottle, and 70% isopropyl alcohol, which you can buy easily online or from a pharmacy. Be careful though, as it is very flammable. To make your cleaning solution, fill your spray bottle halfway with water and fill the other half with 70% isopropyl alcohol. The 70% concentration is said to be less harsh and abrasive on your screen compared to the higher concentration. Now screw the cap back on and give it a good shake. Lightly spray the solution onto your microfiber cloth, then rub it all over your phone, especially the buttons. This guide is for once a week disinfecting. I wouldn't do it every day as it can damage your screen coating, so do it at your own risk or just use a dry microfiber cloth. Let's see how well this method works.
So if you look at the petri dish after cleaning your phone, you can find there is significantly less bacteria compared to the initial test.
It's really incredible to see just how well that quick clean method works.
Yes, in fact, even wiping your phone daily with a dry clean microfiber cloth will remove many microorganisms too.
So I guess to conclude, these microbes won't make us automatically sick, but if they get into our system and we have a weakened immune system, they could potentially make us very ill. Which is why I think it's super important for healthcare professionals in particular to keep their phones stored away whilst at work. Because as we've just seen, phones can be a great reservoir for microbes, and it's going to help the spread from patient to patient. Dr. Isreb also taught me another tip, and that's not to take your phone into the toilet. Because when you flush, the germs spread everywhere. And that's how you get E. coli on your phone. So keep your phone in the other room. It's also important to remember that still the best advice is to wash your hands several times a day properly, and you'll most likely be fine. Now, to watch how to wash your hands properly, the NHS have made a fantastic video, which I've left a link in the description below. And that's it. Let me know what you think of this week's video by leaving a comment below, because I'd love to read it. Being back at the University of Bradford has brought back so many great memories, especially when I was in the School of Pharmacy earlier. A special thank you to Professor Rattray, Dr. Isreb, and Damien, because without you, this video wouldn't have been possible. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.
Yes, no?
Yeah, that's fine. It's just like when you come here and you're like, I couldn't believe it either. Smile, wash your hands, done.
Then a toilet seat. I know. I couldn't believe it either. That was so much smile in that. You
know which one you want me to smile? That was perfect.
These phones can be a reservoir for microbes.
Do you want to come through?
Now let's see what microbes are on my phone. Did you like that one, Jeanette? Should I do one more for you?
Yeah, I think one more.